rivalry. Yes, Ice Train's in the finals, and he will face the winner of this match. Listen to this shitty recording, the British National Anthem. It's like the WWF got like the really good quality one, and WCW was like, oh crap, they're gonna like sue us if we use a good version. Awesome Kong was an indie wrestler from Texas back then, who wrestled just as Awesome Kong. He was just a big, like 400-pound dude. Kind of looked like Juggernaut from X-Men. He called him Venturo. Sounds like a supervillain.
I invited you last year, and I invited you this year, and you chose not to.
Jesse's hair is awful. That guy was the mayor of a city with that hair. Speaking of tans, holy crap, Rick Rude. I think his skin is browner than his hair.
Five-times national arm wrestling champion and finished third in the entire world.
I believe that's a shoot, by the way. Rick Rude really was like the Steve Blackman slash Ken Shamrock, to use a brawl for all analogy. It's just not fair to have him in this if it's going to be a shoot. It was governor of Minnesota a few years after this, but at the time, Terry, he was the mayor of Brooklyn Park, Minnesota.
Your contest. Well, it's too late to enter it, Rick, this year, but I'll tell you what, whoever does come out the champion...
But seriously, Jesse, that's horrible booking. He's like an actual arm wrestler. And you're like, I'm not going to book him in this thing. Even though he wants him. Look at Jesse's pants. We're talking about a shirt earlier. Leather pants.
I understand that, but we've had quarterfinals. This is the final semifinal, and... You know, and it's a little too late to come into the tournament now.
Jesse dressed like Steven Seagal on a cruise.
Davey Boy Smith made love it, Scott. But I'm telling you right now, Jesse, Rick Rude has the strongest arm in all of professional
wrestling. Yeah, Rick Rude, from all intents and purposes, for all intents and purposes, was very into his family.
Let me ask you one simple question.
Very loyal to his wife.
Or did you not?
Mr. Hootman, I'm foot. My arms, my forearms sore. I can't do the arm wrestling match.
Yes, I did.
Imagine Bret Hart carrying British Bulldog through an arm wrestling match.
Because he knows the British Bulldog is the strongest wrestler and in the strongest arm wrestler.
Nick Patrick seems very suspicious.
Today.
He looks like he's poisoned somebody and he's trying not to be figured out.
Wait just a minute. This is between Jesse and I, and this is about the Strongest Arm Tournament. I belong in the tournament, but just due to the fact that I'm five times
national champion.
And you just keep your nose out of my business.
Yeah, Nick Patrick was so tall. Like, I think 6'2", 6'3".
Into my business, and the class, you give me the rude awakening. You want to stick
but imagine going to the hairdresser. Davey Boy Smith sits down next to you to get his braids redone. This is the strongest arm tournament, Jonathan. Jesse the Body's strongest arm tournament. For wrestlers, arm wrestle. Hey, Jared Cheek. Those Diana Hart figures are something. I'll leave it there. This is said there's a reason they had to pair them with the Davy Boy figures to sell them.
Well, ravishing Rick Rude has nailed Davy Boy Smith. The arc.
Okay, now he's screaming, ooh, Mr. Whitman, I'm fooked.
The next contestant, who's Davy Boy's opponent in the semifinals.
And that is the WCW. I want to know everything about Randy Anderson's injury. But since they taped, like, 6 months of the show, that thing probably, his hand probably healed in like 2 weeks, and it's just like broken on this show for half a year. This is unfair.
Hold off,
I would say.
Wait.
Also, They should make him take off those gloves before he arm wrestles. I have to think. That's not allowed in an arm wrestling match. This is probably very similar to how it looked in the hotel room the day of SummerSlam 92. The Diana Hart figure looks like a little German man. With like later hosing. You need to get that check. What? I'm not gonna forfeit. Raise the hand out like he's reciting Macbeth. Man, are you sure? That arm got slammed down hard. Like, this is horrible officiating. Again, arm wrestlers can't slap each other. I'd have to think that's illegal. Everything about this seems like it wouldn't pass a commission. You can't arm wrestle with those gloves on, Vader. So that's the shadiest looking arm wrestling table I've ever seen. Okay, he magically, the gloves disappeared. I didn't see them take them off. They were just gone. Vader's magic gloves. Put your arm on the table. Well, I think Jonathan figured something out, kind of like how, like, you can't have a real boxing match in a wrestling show in a commission state, but you can call it, like, a tough man exhibition and get away with it. They're not calling it arm wrestling, they're calling it strongest arm. And that's how they're getting away with it. Smart move, Jesse Ventura. Also, if I'm Vader, and this man's arm is broken, and he's going to beat me in an arm wrestling match, I would be so embarrassed. Diana Hart figure, I think, was made by maybe Zombie Sailor, I want to say. Also, Vader's not holding on to the grip. Like, blatantly. Yeah. You can tell that, Davey was told, hey, you're doing the job to Vader in this arm wrestling match. And he's like, nope. Diana Hart figure designed by Crazy Steve. Brian. Because he's blind. Vader's not even holding on to the hand. Like, if this is, you can't just let go of the hand, you're going to lose. Vader won despite letting go of the table. Letting go of the hand at one point. That was... Wow. Vader, great professional wrestler, Hall of Famer, the worst worked arm wrestler in history. Jesse looks like a Saudi palace. That's the main event of the of this episode of wrestling television, by the way. Was that terrible arm wrestling match.